the more tools that we have to make sure that we're giving the best care is always a win. And MIIC allows me to really have a good handle on my patients' needs.
You know, I think when you go home at the end of the day, you want to know you made a difference for someone, and it helps us serve patients better. And that's what we want to do.
MIIC is a state of Minnesota tool that gives us the opportunity to record and access a patient's immunization history.
And it also gives you information about what vaccines are due. So you can not only find information, but be proactive and make sure that they get immunized appropriately.
Using MIIC is super easy. You just have to know the patient's name, their birth date. Once you have it, you're able to access right away exactly what you need as far as their immunization history, to look at when they last got their vaccine, where they got it. It's really simple and really user-friendly, and it doesn't add really much more to our workflow than going into a patient profile would.
When a patient goes through any transition of care, we always complete what's called a medication reconciliation, and that involves comparing the medications that they're on at home to the medications that they're taking in the healthcare setting. And often, I think, overlooked part of the medication history is the vaccine history. So if they're behind on their tetanus vaccine or other vaccines that they should be receiving, they can tell by looking at MIIC.
The forecasting tool in the bottom of MIIC is a great resource because it shows us when a patient needs their vaccines and what they're going to be needing. For example, the patient had come and requested her Zostavax vaccine. We pulled her up in MIIC. She'd already had it about 5 years ago, but didn't realize it. Using MIIC, we often will identify patients when we know that they're high risk for certain diseases. It's really easy to assess that if you have diabetes, if you're over a certain age, that you're really a good candidate for certain vaccines.
At the hospital where I work, the majority of the patients who come here are going to be good candidates for a pneumococcal vaccine. So we've taken it upon ourselves to screen all of our patients, and if they need the vaccine, then they receive it. We also have quality measures that we're being measured against, and some of those pertain to immunizations.
When we're assessing a patient for a medication therapy management or MTM visit, there's a pre-screening process we go through. And one of those pre-screening processes is also to look at the immunizations they may need. And when we do an MTM, we're able to bill for the fact that we've assessed for that vaccine need. And then we can also bill for the actual vaccine administration.
We have a requirement to provide good, safe care for our patients, and part of that is making sure that they're appropriately immunized. So if we were all to put information into MIIC and then we could all access it, it's a great tool for us that has consistent information about vaccines.
It makes a lot of sense that we have access to MIIC. It puts us all on the same page for a patient's immunization history and their immunization needs.
Pharmacists are definitely recognized as part of the care team, and the recommendations that they make regarding medications, including immunizations, are taken seriously and followed.
I think as pharmacists, we have a unique position to see a patient on a month-to-month basis, to build a trust relationship that allows us to really be a resource for our patients. And even if we're not immunizing, using MIIC and having access to MIIC helps us to be better prepared to help them make healthcare decisions and to really serve a bigger public health purpose within the healthcare team.